عليك عليك
لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقاتل المسلمون اليهود فيقتلهم المسلمون فيختبئ اليهود وراء الحجر والشجر فينادي الحجر والشجر قائلا يا مسلم يا عبد الله هذا يهودي خلفي تعالى فاقتل إلا الغرقد فإنه من شجر اليهود.
And you have no idea how much I hope Allah is going to curse you to the rest of your life.
You are Ali. Ali.
Hello and welcome everybody. Thank you for joining in. God bless you. That was a really funny thing from Muhammad Hijab. I hope you took out your umbrellas because the people who are sitting in the front row might be wet from all that spitting. Muhammad Hijab, i.e. the spitting cobra. That's his nickname lately, right guys? Hope everybody is doing okay. Thank you for being here. Today's topic is Signs of a Hypocrite Munafiq, featuring Muhammad Hijab. Guys, I hope you are not wet from all the spinning, are you? Always make sure, you know, when we are talking about Muhammad Hijab, always make sure to bring out your umbrella, right? Because you never know, you know, like Zach and Ike, when these people talk, they have to, for some reason, they have to spit all over the place. It is what it is, guys. It is what it is. Signs of a Hypocrite Munafiq, featuring Muhammad Hijab. Why did I pick today's topic, guys? Because Muhammad Hijab, he uploaded a video on his YouTube channel. And you know me, whenever these people speak, we need to expose them and show their hypocrisy, right? This guy is nothing but a hypocrite. He has no clue about Islam. He loves to talk about Islam and he has many subscribers. But we're going to show you that this guy is nothing but a hypocrite like his prophet, right? Yeah, good morning, people. Let me say hi to our friends who just joined in. Hello, Radioactive, Naomi Pat, M-Man, Ravinder, ZH Pro, Sequel, World Changer, Devil Chaser. We are blessed. Carrie Ann, how are you, sister? Tenshi Cannon, Do Town, Jason Palmer, how are you? TM Crosspulse, always nice to see you here, my friend. Potter, Christ is Lord. Single is awesome. Shannon Mitchell, our dear admin Phil Herrera. Guys, tell our friends that we are live. Invite your friends. Share the link of today's live show on social media. Please let people know that we are live. Also, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button, guys. Destroy that like button and click on the notification bell to receive notifications when we go live or upload new videos. Before we start, guys, before we start, let us pray in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ so we can be guided through today's live show. So hopefully, Lord willing, our live stream is going to be healthy. If the Lord wills. Pray in the name of our Lord and Savior with me, guys. Pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Dear Lord, bless our beloved audience. Lord, thank you for your grace. Thank you for the ultimate sacrifice. Jesus coming in the flesh, dying for our sins. Lord, we know we can't help ourselves. We need you. We need your blessings. We need the Holy Spirit to fill us and to bless us and guide us. Lord, thank you for the amazing last year, 2019. Thank you, Lord, for my lovely audience and subscribers who kept supporting us in the last year, day in, day out. Please bless them. Bless the audience and their families. Please God, keep all of us healthy and safe in this new year, in 2020. Father, enfold us in your arms. Help us not to lean on our own understanding, but in everything acknowledge you, Lord, so that you can direct our words, actions, and thoughts. Please give us a measure of your strength, Lord, so that we might not give into discouragement, taqiyya, deception, lies, or any doubt, Lord. Please help us honor you in all our ways. Lord, fill me with your Holy Spirit and loosen my tongue today so I can speak the truth to our audience, Lord. The truth and only the truth matters, Lord, without any error or any shame, because we should not be ashamed about the truth, Lord. Lord, give me wisdom and courage to do whatever needs to be done today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Welcome, everybody. As we mentioned on this live broadcast today, we will have the opportunity to see if there are any signs of a hypocrite or a munafiq in Islam. And today's sponsor is Muhammad Hijab. Yes, he's the one who's sponsoring today's live show, guys. So, and you saw him spitting all over the place. Right, this guy, every couple of words he starts to spit. Every couple of words he starts. What is this, man? Anyway, last but not least, when I finish my teaching, guys, we'll have a nice Q&A session with our guests in the live chat. If you have any questions, guys, as Christians, please hold your horses, keep your questions to yourself for now. But when the Q&A session starts in after the teaching, you can ask us all kind of questions. If you need help, we will try to answer your questions as far as we can. If there are Muslims, you can call us live. Let me open up my Skype. What's happening? Why can't I not open Skype? What's going on? Oh, no. Okay, now it works. If you can, if you're a Muslim and you want to call me, guys, and you think you have the courage and knowledge to refute me, my Skype is open, right? Look, my Skype is open. Welcome, Rob Christian. My Skype ID is Rob Christian if you want to call me and if you're a Muslim. If you're a Christian, you have to wait, guys, after we are done teaching in the live Q&A session, okay? If you want to call us as a Christian, you have to wait. So only the Muslims can call us for now, all right? Now, let us start our today's live show by saying the following.
Tonight, we are going to witness the most anticipated match in the history of professional wrestling. For the heavyweight championship of the world. Are you ready? Wrestling fans, are you ready? For the thousands in attendance, and the millions watching around the world, from the capital city of the United States of America, Washington, D.C., ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Are you ready? I said, are you ready? I hope you're ready, because I'm ready, guys. That means you have to be ready, right? Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining in. PG Coffee, thank you very much. Let me read what PG Coffee said. By the way, congratulations to Rob for happiness in the family. God bless you. Thank you, my friend. That's very, very sweet of you. Yes, guys, for the people who didn't join us in my last live show, I gave everybody the good news that I'm going to be a father of a baby boy very soon. So yeah, we did a gender reveal to our family and it was really a blessed day. We had a lot of fun together with the family, both families, me and my wife. It was really wonderful and a blessing. God is good, guys. Yeah. So praise to God. Thank you, God, for that blessing. Thank you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jehovah, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Guys, let us start today's live show. Signs of a hypocrite, munafiq. A munafiq, that's the Arabic word for a hypocrite. Featuring Muhammad Hijab. Muhammad Hijab needs always to spit when he debates a Christian. He did it on the debate with David Wood, and he also did it with the so-called debate. There was no debate, actually. They were muting Christian Prince. He again did it on, as you saw the video, the intro video. He did that with Christian Prince. The same hypocrite munafiq, Muhammad Hijab, who fears the tsunami of ex-Muslims. He and Ali Dawa actually spoke on Speaker's Corner and they were really angry, right? Angry. There are so many Muslims leaving Islam. Come on, we have to do something. What are you going to do? According to Al Jazeera, number one news TV show or news TV channel in the Arabic world, Al Jazeera. According to Al Jazeera, guys, 17,000 Muslims leave Islam a day. That means more than 6 million Muslims leave Islam every year. More than 6 million Muslims leave Islam every year. Can you imagine? So I understand why Mimi Hijab and Lili Ali Dawa are so angry why Muslims are leaving Islam. And they're actually blaming the West and the Christians for that. Can you imagine? 70,000 a day, yeah, 17,000 a day leave Islam, Muslims. If you, do that with 365 days, that means at least 6 million Muslims are leaving Islam every year. Actually, around 6,200,000 Muslims. Can you imagine? Can you imagine how Islam is dying? Islam is actually dying and Muslims cannot do anything about it. Yeah, very big numbers, exactly. The same Muhammad Hijab, guys, who lost that debate with David Wood. He lost that debate. He knew he got spanked by David Wood. Because on that debate, he said, this is why the translators, and I quote, quote unquote, that's what Muhammad Hijab said. This is why the translators put Allah praise for, not to the Prophet. Then he went to Africa, to Ghana, and he came back to London and he said, no, I meant to say, sorry, I meant to say Allah praises the Prophet. But wait a second, ya hypocrite munafiq Muhammad Hijab. According to chapter 1, ayah 2 of the Quran, Alhamdulillah faqat. Alhamd is only for Allah. Alhamdulillah faqat. Only for Allah, right? All praise to Allah. So are you telling me that Allah became the slave of the Prophet? Because if you're going to say that Allah praises, is doing hamd to the Prophet, that means this is shirk. Crystal clear shirk. Crystal clear blasphemy, Mr. Muhammad Hijab. This is blasphemy. So you are a blasphemer, you are out of Islam, Mr. Muhammad Hijab. Ya munafiq murtad. Shame on you for calling yourself a Muslim. So shave this long beard, shave it. Actually, guys, if I was a Muslim and I was listening when this guy said, Allah praises to the Prophet. If I was a Muslim, I would have grabbed him by his beard. I kid you not. I would have grabbed him by his beard, this very beautiful beard of him, of his, grabbed him by the beard and dragged him over the floor. What are you saying? Ya Munafiq Murtad. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah faqat ya Gizzab ibn Gizzab. You liar. Shame on you. Are you even a Muslim? You just called Allah the slave of Muhammad. You just committed huge blasphemy. You blasphemer? Let it sink, guys. Let it sink. It is what it is. Whenever a Muslim speak or debate, they're going to get spanked anyway. Right? Do we have any Muslim guys who wants to... Guys, please, my friends, Christians, please don't send me a hello on Skype. What's the point? Why are you doing that, Christians? Come on, man. Don't waste my time, okay? If you wanna call me, you have to wait. Call me when we are done, okay? As a Christian. But if you are a Muslim, you can call me right here, right now. All right? Don't send me messages like, hey, hello, Rob Christian. What's the point, guys? Come on. Do you want some attention? Anyway, so as you see, Muhammad Hijab is actually a munafiq, a hypocrite. This is a sign of a hypocrite, right? Instead of doing damage control, he's making it even more worse for his Allah and Muhammad, his prophet. So actually, this guy is proving to us that he's a worshipper of Muhammad. Yeah, Muhammad Hijab, you are the worshipper of the Prophet of Islam. This is why we always say Sunni Muslims worship Muhammad, and Shia worship the Ahlul Bayt, the household, the family of Muhammad. Do you see? Do you see? Do you see why we chose today's topic, guys? Signs of a hypocrite, of a munafiq. Right? You see what kind of pagans these people are. If you go to the hadith, guys, if you go to the hadith, please let everybody know that we are live, guys. Invite your friends. Share the link on social media. Let me give you the link, guys, so you can share it in the live chat. Help me to help you, guys. If you go to the hadith, if you go to Sunan Ibn Majah, we can read the following. It was narrated from Qabisha bin Hulb that his father said, I asked the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, about the food of the Christians. So the Sahabi, the companion, asked Muhammad about the food of the Christians. And Muhammad said, now Muhammad said, the Prophet of Islam said, do not have any doubt about food, thereby following the ways of the Christians in that. So it's okay to eat the food of the Christians. Guys, pay attention. According to the Prophet of Islam, it is okay, it's halal to eat the food of the Christians. Right, Muslims? According to your Prophet, you can eat the food of the Christians. But wait, Christians eat pork. Christians, they eat pork. What did your Prophet said? Don't have any doubt about the food of the Christians, following the way of the Christians in that. What? In the food. So according to your Prophet, you can eat pork because Christians prepare pork. Right? Christians, they prepare pork. Is this a contradiction? Yes or no? Yes, it is. Muhammad busted himself and contradicted himself. How can you eat the food of Christians if Christians eat pork? Muslims, do you see how kind of hypocrite munafiq your prophet was? Do you have any Muslim guys? If you have a Muslim, he can call us live on Skype. My Skype is open. Install Skype. Add your account and call us live. My Skype ID is the Rob Christian. Maybe the admins can provide it in the live chat. The Rob Christian. So we have a contradiction here. Yes, we do. And if we go to chapter 5, ayah 5, Surah Al-Ma'idah, guys, take notes. Chapter 5, ayah 5, it says, this day all good foods have been made lawful, and the food of those who were given the scripture, i.e. the Jews and the Christians, is lawful for you. Do you see it? Again, even the Quran. You know, some Muslims maybe reject hadith. But what about the Quran, brother? The yellow pages of Muhammad. Even in the Quran, you are allowed, it's lawful for you to eat pork of the Christians. Pork of the Christians, brother. Do you see it? So if you can eat the food of the Christians and the Jews, that means you can eat pork. You see how Muhammad forgot about the pork, guys? If you are a true prophet and you are not a munafiq hypocrite, are you going to bust yourself or not? Yeah, the Quran, brother, this ayah is da'if, brother. This ayah in the Quran is da'if. Weak, brother, da'if. Quran is da'if? Yes, brother. Right? What about another contradiction? If we go back to chapter 5, guys, if we continue reading, it says, it's lawful for you to marry, right? It's lawful for you to marry women from the Jews and the Christians. Do you see it? And chaste women from among those who were given the scripture before you, who are the Jews and the Christians. So according to chapter 5, again, not only the food of the Jews and the Christians is lawful, right? Eating pork of the Christians is lawful, but also marry the women of the Christians and the Jews. Welcome, Princess Rainbow. Nice to have you here too. God bless you, sister. God bless everybody who just joined. Please invite your friends, share the link to today's live show. Lasari, I'm not CP. Lasari, I'm not CP. I'm Rob Christian. There's no need to call Christian Prince because Christian Prince is not live yet. You're confusing me with Christian Prince. Anyway, so among those who were given the scripture before you, so those are the women of the Jews and the Christians. But if we go to chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 221, it says, do not marry mushrik women unless they believe, unless they become Muslims. Did you catch it? So this ayah says, it's okay to marry Jews and Christian women, but this ayah says, do not marry mushrik women. But wait, are Jews and Christians mushrik? Can Muslim marry Christian women? That's the question. Are they mushrikeen? Are they mushrikat? Yes, they are. Because the Jews say in chapter 9, Surah At-Tawbah, ayah 30, the Jews say, Uzair is Allah's son. And the Christians say, the Messiah is the son of Allah. These are merely verbal essentials in imitation of the saying of those unbelievers who preceded them. May Allah ruin them. Do you see it? We are actually mushrikeen. Do you see it? So here we have another contradiction. Can Muslims marry Christian and women? You tell me. If I was a Muslim, I would be very confused because of the Quran. Because the Quran is contradicting itself. Muhammad fabricating ayahs, busting himself. Ya munafiq, son of a munafiq. You hypocrite, fake, scam prophet of Islam. Can Muhammad have a cake and eat it too and call himself a prophet, but at the same time contradicting himself and his Allah in the Quran? We know Muhammad is the one who created the Quran, guys. Right? And Zakir Naik says, brother makes a good point. Let it sink in, Muslims. Can Allah called God, can Allah be God and at the same time contradict himself? Can Muhammad be called prophet and contradict himself at the same time? Yes, Princess Rainbow, they lie to you because Muslims don't read their Quran. You cannot marry. You cannot marry Christian women or Jewish women according to the Quran, because we Jews and Christians, we call Ezra, they called Ezra, there's nothing called Ezra. Uzair is Allah's son. And the Christians say Messiah is the son of Allah. Do you see it? Allah is actually saying, may Allah ruin those Jews and Christians. So we are mushrikat, mushrikeen, right? Actually, the word is tenkahu, right? There's nothing called marry, it's sexual intercourse. So don't have sexual intercourse with the mushrikati, right? The mushrik women, don't have sex with them until they become Muslims. Brother makes a good point. Tinkahu, yeah, tinkahu. Don't F mushrikat, i.e. non-believers, right? I.e. women who associate partners with Allah, i.e. Uzair, i.e. the Messiah. You see it? So this is why we are called mushrikeen, Jews and Christians. Right? When you ask a Muslim, are Christians or Jews, are they believers? They will say no, they are mushrikeen. They associate partners with Allah. Right? The Jews call Ezra the son of Allah, and the Christians call Isa, that's what they call Jesus, the son of Allah. How Allah will ruin them. This is why they are cursing us day in, day out. This is why Muslims, when they pray, they repeat the curses of Allah on the Jews and the Christians. In Surah Al-Fatiha, right? Daniel Kamasi. Really, my friend? Daniel Kamasi, look what Daniel Kamasi is saying. I think there are two kinds of Christians and Jews. Those who follow Allah's Bible and others who are mushrikeen. What are you talking about? Do Jews and Christians follow Allah? Daniel, are you going to make a cake and eat it too? Are you going to have a cake and eat it too, Daniel? Show me one Jew, show me one Christian who believes in Allah. Just one. Show me one Jew who has in his Hebrew Bible the word Allah. Show me one Christian who reads his original Greek manuscripts and has in his Greek manuscripts the word Allah. I'll give you $1,000, Daniel. Show me, man. I will give you $1,000. Silence is bliss. But Muhammad actually lied about, especially the Jews, right? Because the Jews never said Uzair is Allah's son. And the Christians, he lied about the Christians. The Christians don't say the Messiah is the son of Allah. We don't believe in Allah in the first place. Jews don't believe in Allah. Christians don't believe in Allah. Christians believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What are you talking about, Daniel? Anyway. So brother makes a good point. Muhammad lied about the Jews. Muhammad lied that you can marry Jewish women and Christian women because you cannot have a cake and eat it too, Mr. Muhammad, because you are calling the Jewish women and Christian women, because they are associating partners with Allah, mushrikat. So you're saying in another ayah, وَلَا تَنْكَحُوا الْمُشْرِكَاتِ, don't have sex with the mushrik women. Brother makes a good point. Can Muslims marry Christian women? No. So why are you doing that, Muslims? According to the Quran, you cannot. Why are you doing that? Because you are hypocrite, munafiq, son of munafiq. You are hypocrites, Muslims. Like Muhammad Hijab, as we showed you in the beginning of the live show. Right? So can Muslims marry Christian women? No. The answer is no. And Zakir Naik says, brother makes a good point. We have another sponsor, Brother Fifi. Brother Fifi is another sponsor. He's the sub-sponsor, the co-sponsor, together with the spitting cobra, Muhammad Hijab. Right? Muhammad Hijab. Do we have a contradiction? Yes. Yes, Christian Prince teaches, that's correct. If that's a different story, Christian Prince teaches. Let me quote what he said. Rob Christian, but it's not forbidden to rape captive mushrikeen women. That's correct. But that's a different story, right? That's a different story. When you are having war as a Muslim, you're going to do jihad, and you come to a Christian, let's say, and the Christian doesn't want to pay jizya. As a Muslim, you are allowed to force jizya, mafia protection money, i.e. jizya, on a Christian. And that Christian refuses to pay jizya. And you warn him, you say to him, okay, you don't want to pay jizya, you have to leave the country. If still the Christian, that Christian male, doesn't want to leave the country that you conquered, his own country that you conquered of him, you are a usurper, you took the country of the Christian, and he still doesn't want to leave, then you can kill him and take his women, his daughters, the Christian women and daughters, as sex slaves, as captives, as booty. Yes, that's the final step, right? Right, guys? Guys, I want to play a video for you. I want to play... Who's that in the picture? I took a picture of a beautiful woman, you know, because Muslims always love to, you know, love women. So when we use pictures of women, they come, you know, they see it, they will come. So it's basically a tactic, right, guys? This is, I think, she's an actor. She's a French actor. She also played Mary Magdalene in The Passion of Christ, guys. This woman. Do you remember her? Mary Magdalene. She played Mary Magdalene in The Passion of the Christ movie. Yeah, Catherine Zeta-Jones, if I'm not mistaken, that's her name. She's a French lady, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe she lives in America, in the United States, I don't know. I have no idea. So, let me play a video, guys, for you. Of Mimi Hijab. This is why I actually did today's live show, because of the hypocrisy of Muhammad Hijab. Let me show you his hypocrisy, guys. Put your headsets on and watch the following video of Muhammad Hijab. Let me play it, okay, guys? Focus.
فشيخ نبدأ بالحديث. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث لستتبعن سنن من كان قبلكم شبرا شبرا ذراعا بذراع حتى إذا دخلوا جحر ضب اتبعتموهم.
Okay, guys, to make it clear, right? To make it clear for you, maybe it's hard sometimes because they are now talking Arabic. This is a sheikh, you know, he's sitting with a sheikh, a real sheikh who has a degree in Islam, and Muhammad Hijab, they are having a conversation about a hadith where Muhammad said, you know, he warned the Muslims that you will imitate the Jews and the Christians. You're going to copy the Jews and the Christians in their religious habits. Right? So he's mentioning that hadith. He's talking about that hadith where Muhammad said, you Muslims, he's talking to his Sahaba, you're going to copy the Jews and the Christians in their religious habits. Right?
الآن نرى في الغرب يا شيخ نرى في طبعا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هنا نبهنا على أن المسلمون سيقلدوا
they're copying the Jews and the Christians
ونرى في الغرب الآن في بريطانيا وفي أمريكا نرى كثير من النصارى يلحدون يكونوا ملحدين يعني يرتدون عن دينهم فهل ترى نفس هذه الظاهرة في الشرق الأوسط
is it also for the Muslims he says
بالنسبة لل يعني الحديث اللي ذكرت عن
he's talking now about the hadith the sheikh
نبوة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن هذه التجليات والمظاهر اللي تنبأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بوقوعها في الأمة يعني إحنا نشاهد فعلا وقوع على مستويات متعددة يعني يمثل حالة التطرف المتعلقة بها ما يتعلق ب أن يختاروا نفس الخيار
wait So guys, they are saying, they are basically saying in a nutshell, yeah, the, you know, we see that the Muslims also, you know, they become basically like the Jews and the Christians. They are copying, even in the Middle East, even in the Arabic countries where actually Islam started, they are copying the Jews and the Christians. Well, that's correct. I mean, guys, just a second. Wait. Ya Muhammad Hijab, Ya Munafiq, and you Sheikh. Ya Munafiq, son of a Munafiq. Why I'm calling them hypocrites, guys? Here is why. If you see their microphones, look at the microphones, guys. Are you with me? Look at their microphones. Do you know what kind of microphones those are? This microphone that you see here is the same microphone that Michael Jackson himself used when he recorded the album of Thriller, guys. The Thriller album, the same microphone. Do you see it? This is a huge, expensive microphone. So why are you copying the Jews and the Christians? The Jews and the Christians made this microphone, brother. You are talking about hypocrisy. You are talking about copying Jews and Christians. But the Jews and the Christians made this microphone. And you're using a very expensive microphone. Look, guys. This is a Shure SM7B. This is a studio microphone. Look how expensive this one. It's a 315 pounds microphone. Man. This one is made by the Jews and the Christians. You're talking about hypocrisy. You're talking about Muslims who copy the Jews and the Christians. But you yourself are copying the Jews and Christians. You are using a very expensive Jewish Christian microphone that is created in the West. Guys, this is the same microphone that Michael Jackson used when he recorded his world famous Thriller songs and album. This is on topic, guys. This is on topic. What about their clothing? Look at his clothes. Where do you think his clothes are made from, guys? Look at his beautiful jacket and his blouse, his t-shirt. Do you think this t-shirt is made in the UK? Yes or no? Yes. Western made. So look at these hypocrites, man. You're talking about hypocrisy. You're talking about hypocrisy, but the hypocrisy is on you. Look, guys, this is a $315 or let's say pounds mic. Another one. We have at least 630 equipment. 630 pounds equipment. Can you imagine? Western equipment. You hypocrite. Look at the professional decoration behind them and the LED lights. Where do you think the LED lights are created? Where do you think this is all created? In the West, by Western people, by mushrikeen. What about your pants? I can't see the pants. What about the panties that you are... Maybe this guy, you know, he gets a lot of donations. Right? What about his Bjornborg or Bjornborg? Or maybe Tommy Hilfiger or... Who do you think made Tommy Hilfiger or Bjornborg? Western people. Yeah, even the studio setup is of Western style. Exactly. So you're talking about hypocrisy, but you yourself are a hypocrite. What about your glasses? Arab oil people, Arab Saudi people made these glasses for you. Arabs created your glasses. No, you probably bought them in a glasses shop somewhere in the UK, right, Mimi Hijab? Brother Mimi Hijab? Look at those glasses, man. Look at the glows, man. Hypocrite, son of a hypocrite. That's what you are, Muslims. You hypocrite, you son of a hypocrite. Do you see now, guys, why I brought this topic up today? If we go to the hadith, guys, if we go to Sunan Abi Dawud, it says the following. Narrated Abu Huraira. The Prophet is saying, the Prophet said, Jews and Christians, right, do not dye their beards, so act differently from them. Don't copy the Jews and the Christians. What? But the Jew, but those Muslims are copying us. Look at the Muslims here in the West, man. Go even to Saudi Arabia. Go to Medina. Go to Iraq. Go to Egypt, where you have Al Azhar University. Go to Cairo. Go to Iraq. You will see they are actually have the same style that we have. Their hair looks the same. Even their beards look the same. Their mustache look like us. They copy-paste us, man. Are you calling Muhammad a liar, Muslims, when you do that? Go to Turkey. They drink even more alcohol than you and me, my friends. Go to Istanbul. Those Muslims there, they are drinking more alcohol than you and me. Go even to Saudi Arabia. You will have underground clubs where they are clubbing in Saudi Arabia, in the heart of Saudi Arabia. They are drinking and using drugs more than you and me. Yes, this is Saudi Arabia. Go to Dubai. You see these hypocrite munafiq Muslims? So are you telling me, Muhammad, when you say don't copy the Jews and the Christians? Muhammad, you prophet of Allah. Are you telling me when you don't want to try to copy the Jews and the Christians, are you telling us that Islam is not an Abrahamic religion? This is why you are trying to avoid copying the Jews and the Christians? Is that what you're saying, Muslims? Are you telling us that Islam is not an Abrahamic religion? We know it is not, but that's what you're actually confirming. Is that what you're confirming, that Islam is not an Abrahamic religion? This is why you try to avoid to copy us. Yes, that's why, right? We understand, brother. Contradiction on top of contradiction. And Zekernik says, brother makes a good point. The brother makes a good point. Muslims are trying actually to prove to us that Islam is not an Abrahamic religion. Let me show you, on top of that, let me show you more hypocrisy from the Prophet of Islam, i.e. Muhammad. We were with the Prophet, this is a hadith from sunnah.com. We were with the Prophet when a funeral passed by and he stood up for it. So Muhammad stood up when a funeral passed by. Guys, pay attention. Muhammad was seeing there's a funeral, right? Couple of people, you know, they carried the coffin of a dead guy. And he stood up out of respect, right, guys? So the Prophet of Islam stood up. When we went to carry it, so when the Muslims when the Muslims went to help and carry the coffin, we found that it was a funeral of a Jew. So it was a Jewish funeral for a Jew, a dead Jew, right? We therefore said, Messenger of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, O Muhammad, this is the funeral of a Jew, man. Muhammad, Prophet of Allah, Ya Rasulallah, this is a funeral of a Jew, a Jew. Are you paying attention, Muhammad? Muhammad said, oops, Muhammad said, death is fearful event. So when you see a funeral, stand up, stand up. So every Muslim from now on, when you see a funeral of a Jew, even if a Jew, you have to stand up. You, as a Muslim, must stand up when you see a Jewish funeral. Guys, pay attention. Now, I'm going to show you the hypocrisy of Muhammad. So here he says, stand up. When I say to you, jump, you have to say how high. Basically, that's what Muhammad is saying. So if I stand up, you must stand up. So Muhammad stood up and they stood up with him, the Muslims. Right, guys? Did you catch it? So you have to stand up. Did you catch it, guys? Now, if we go to another hadith, it says the following, the Messenger of Allah, S-A-W-S, used to stand up for a funeral until the corpse was placed in the grave. Again, you know, stand up, brother, brother, stand up. A learned Jew once passed him and said, this is how we do it. This is how we do it. It's Friday night and I feel all right. Yeah, guys, I have his the vibe of, you know, the night. This is how we do it. It's Friday. Yeah, guys. So the Jew says, this is how we do it. Okay. Then the Prophet, so S-A-W-S, sat down. Now he's sitting down. And said, sit down and act differently. Sit down and act differently. But brother, earlier you said, even if it's a funeral of a Jew, you have to stand up, brother. Stand up, brother. Now Muhammad changed his mind. Look at this hypocrite prophet of Islam. Aha! Bam! This is how we do it, says the Jews. This is how we do it. It's right. Yeah. This is how we do it. And Muhammad says, you know, he answers, sit down and act differently. Sit down. Yeah. You see this hypocrite prophet, guys? You see this hypocrite prophet? You see the hypocrisy of Muhammad? First time, he says, whenever you see, even if it's a funeral of a Jew, stand up out of respect of for the dead guy. But now changes his mind and says, sit down and act differently. This water is good, man. You know, Muhammad, I'm drinking on your hypocrisy. And you're showing everybody in your hadith. Whenever we read the hadith, we see the hypocrisy of this Muhammad, this so-called prophet of Islam. I'm having a half time. I'm having a fun time, my friend. I'm singing for you guys. What do you want more? Singing is haram. This is why. Okay, guys. Somebody singing is haram. Don't sing anymore, Rob Christian. All right. Do we have any Muslim? Sahih contradiction. Tom Crosspools is saying Sahih. Speaking from Cave Hira, this is Sahih, Hassan, Hassan, Sahih, Sahih, Hadith, Hadith. Brother. Yeah, this is actually Hassan, brother. You cannot reject it, brother. Hassan. Sunan Abi Dawud, hadith number 3176. Let me give you the link, brother. You see it? Sit down and act differently from them, from who? The Jews. But brother, in the last hadith you said, stand up even if it's a Jew. Do we have a contradiction, guys? Muslims, do we have a contradiction? Is there any Muslim who dares to call us? We are life. You can call us life on air. And if you think you have the knowledge and the courage, call me life, brother. And Fifi Hijab says, no, 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 it doesn't say that, brother. Brother. Fifi Farid will say, no, it doesn't say that, Rob Christian. Sit down, and move it all around. Yeah. So Muhammad, which one, if I am Muslim, brother, if I am a Muhammadan, if I am a follower of Muhammad, should I stand up? I'm confused, brother. I am a confused Muslim. Brother, I'm a confused Muslim. Which one should I do? Should I stand up or should I sit down, brother? We have a Muslim. He says, "It there are two hadith that seem contradicted. Follow the strong one, the mutawatir. Don't be confused. Brother, this is Hassan, brother. We cannot reject it, brother. Brother, this one is sahih, brother. But this one is Hassan, brother. Both pass, brother. Brother, are you telling me Muhammad contradicts himself and, you know, follow the strong hadith as always, brother. Brother, this is Hassan. You cannot reject it. This is not da'if. This is not weak, brother. Don't be a hypocrite like your prophet, brother. You hypocrite, Abdul. Ya Muslim man jawab. Ya Muslim man jawab. Call me. My Skype is open. Tell everybody. Hassan has little source, brother? No, brother. Hassan is very good, brother. Hassan means good, brother. You liar. Little, brother. No, not little. It's good, brother. هذا الحديث حسن. It means this hadith is good. You liar, you son of a liar. You are a hypocrite like your prophet. That's what you are. Brother, this is Hassan. Sit down and act differently from them. You see these hypocrite Muslims, guys? You know what good means? Guys, this guy doesn't know the meaning of good. Someone needs to tell him what the meaning of good is. It means little, brother. Little. Brother, Hassan means little. Not good, it means little. It means little source, brother. You liar. You munafiq, you hypocrite, son of a hypocrite. That's what you are. Call me, man. My Skype is open. Call me. Brother, why are you not calling me? Look. You know, I prepared some kufta and I will give you even a nice cup of coffee. Look, we have an admin. He can make a nice cup of tea for you if you like. We will have some hummus and shish kebab and falafel on the side if you call. Don't worry. Be happy, man. Look at these cowards, man. If you know Islam so good, you can call me and maybe you can refute me, brother. Think Allah or Jibreel silenced him. Why was the guy? He suddenly disappeared. What happened, brother? You're trying to lie to everybody, say that Hassan Hadith is only little brother, and then we bust you, brother, and show you that Hassan means good, and now you're silent, fi sabil Allah, brother? Yeah, someone's saying falafel munafiqs. Brother, this is Hassan, brother. It's past. It's not daif. What a joke. Look at this comedy, guys. Look at brother Hassan is little brother. Who are you lying to, man? Don't you know that all these Christians that are sitting in the live chat, guys, we always eat 7 ajwa before we start the live show. Right? Phil Herrera, do you see Phil Herrera with that blue name, that admin? He always buys for everybody here, everyone gets 7 ajwa. So we can be immune for lies, taqiyya, right? Poison and black magic, brother. We get the extra because we are Christians, brother. We are people of the book. We get immune for taqiyya, brother. That's the extra, the bonus. On top of the black magic, right? And the poison, brother. Yeah. Our dear brother, Phil Herrera, always goes to the market and he buys 7 ajwa for everybody. Yeah, we eat them every morning, brother. See? Oh, man. Try not to laugh with these people, man, with these jokers. Try not to laugh, guys. Let me show you another hypocrisy from Muhammad, guys. The hypocrite Munafiq prophet of Islam. And let me show you how the followers of Muhammad are nothing but Munafiqs. On his deathbed, Allah's apostle, Muhammad, put a sheet over his face. So Muhammad is about to die, right? Muhammad is going to die. I wonder why Allah didn't save him from the poison, brother. Why didn't Allah send Muhammad a dish of 7 ajwa that morning before the Jewish woman poisoned Muhammad? I mean, 7 ajwa makes you immune for poison. The Jewish woman, she caused Muhammad to die. And Muhammad became so ill, guys, he even started to forbid alcoholic drinks, right? Haram, brother. You know, Muhammad was really envy. He was jealous of his sahaba who used to go drunk to the masjid, to the mosque. Right? He told them, don't do it anymore, man. Because this guy could not drink anymore. He could not party with his homeboys, the sahaba, anymore. So Allah's apostle on his deathbed put a sheet over his face. And when he felt hot, he would remove it from his face. Okay, that's, you know, thank you for the information. Thank you for the FYI. When in that state of putting and removing the sheet, he said, may Allah's curse be on the Jews. How kind of you. How kind of you to curse the Jews and the Christians, brother Muhammad. May Allah's curse be on the Jews and the Christians. For they build places of worship at the grace of their prophets. By that, he intended to warn the Muslim from what they, i.e. the Jews and the Christians, had done. So, according to Muhammad, we are building places of worship at the graves of their prophet, of our prophets. Right? May Allah la'nat Allah ala al-Yahud wal-Nasara. Right? May Allah's curse. Look at this beautiful, peaceful, loving prophet of Islam, brother. Look at this peaceful, merciful, beautiful, best of all mankind, brother. The best example of mankind. Cursing Jews and Christians left and right. And we Christians always say, and we repeat after Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. Exactly, Jason Palmer. Thank you for the verse. We are actually asking our holy living God to forgive our enemies, right? But Muhammad, the prophet of Satan, i.e. Allah, curses Jews left and right. Every morning Muhammad, when he woke up, he asked Allah, he invoked Allah to curse such and such and such and such person, according to different hadith. But guys, so here, Muhammad is cursing Jews and Christians. But today, oops! Guys, this is supposedly the tomb of Muhammad in Medina. Right? This is the tomb of Muhammad in Medina. What are Muslims doing, brother? What are Muslims doing here at the tomb of Muhammad, brother? Whenever they go to Medina, this is how we do it. Look how they are praying to Muhammad, guys. To a dead man. They are praying to dead Muhammad. Bam on your faces, Muslims. I know if you're a Muslim, you would go, you would do the same. You hypocrite, munafiq Muslims. This is the tomb of Muhammad in Medina, guys. You know, you remember my video, guys? My short video that I created, where we showed you when Muslims actually pray, when they pray 70 times, you know, they pray 5 times and they repeat everything 70 times, right? 5 times a day, they must do 5 prayers. They say, Salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh, right? So they are actually praying to Muhammad. And they are actually showing us how they are physically now doing it at his tomb. Yes, exactly, we are blessed. Exactly. They are speaking to the dead prophet when they pray 5 times a day. Salamu alayka, peace be upon you, O prophet. Salamu alayka, ayyuhan nabi. Peace be upon you. Who? Muhammad. So they are talking to a dead guy, dead Muhammad. And when they pray. So when they pray, guys, take notes. When Muslims pray, right, they say, peace be upon you, who? Muhammad. So they are talking to Muhammad. So when you pray, you are worshiping, right? It's an act of worship. Pray or praying is act of worship. So they are worshiping Muhammad. And as you see, they are bowing and worshipping Muhammad in Medina. Look! Pew! 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 Yeah. Look at the butts, man. Brother. You are praying and talking to Muhammad, the dead Muhammad, in front of his tomb. Look at their behinds, man. Praying to Muhammad, brother? With their butts up high? Let it sink, guys. Muslims, let it sink, brother. This is Medina. This is the tomb of Muhammad, brother. The grave of Muhammad, brother. You munafiq, hypocrite Muslims. Shame on you. You'd love to talk about hypocrisy. But who is the hypocrite now? Who is the hypocrite now? Who is the munafiq now? Mimi Hijab? Mimi Hijab? The same Mimi Hijab, guys, as we mentioned earlier, right? When he lost the debate with David Wood, remember that famous David Wood debate? When he said, this is why the translators, quote unquote, put in their translation, Allah prays for, not to, to a prophet. Then he came back and he said, I made a mistake. Forgive me. I meant to say Allah praises the prophet. You munafiq, son of a munafiq. Muhammad Hijab, you munafiq, son of a munafiq. You hypocrite. According to chapter 1, ayah 2 of the Quran, chapter 1, ayah 2 of the Quran, Alhamdulillah faqat. All praise to Allah alone. So how? Are you telling me Allah is doing hamd? Allah is doing praise to the Prophet? Are you telling me that Allah is worshipping the Prophet? Because alhamd is only for Allah. So are you telling me that Allah became the servant? Allah became the slave of Muhammad? Is that what you're trying to say now? So he's doing damage control, but at the same time, he's showing everybody that he is a worshipper of Muhammad. This Muhammadan here. You see how hamd, guys, is an act of worship, right? Alhamdulillah faqad. Let me show you. Chapter 1, ayah 2. All praise is to Allah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All praise is to Allah, Lord of the worlds. I don't know how many worlds there are, but anyway. Lord of the worlds. All praise is to Allah and Allah alone. You munafiq. You hypocrite. Mimi Hijab. Is this guy even a Muslim, guys? Gabriel Moses, welcome, my friend. God bless you. I'm really happy for you that you left Islam and became a Christian. God bless you, my friend. And we always have our dear sister Hafsa, who is a daughter of an imam. She is also an ex-Muslim, became a Christian. You cannot be sincere with yourself and be a Muslim in 2020 if you don't see the hypocrisy in Islam. If you don't see the hypocrisy of Muhammad and the Muslims who are praying to Muhammad. When you pray in your five daily prayers, you say, Salamu alayka ya ayyuhan nabiyu, or Salamu alayka ayyuhan nabiyu. So they are talking directly to Muhammad. Peace be upon you, O Nabi, O Prophet. They are talking to a dead guy when they pray. Shame on you, Muslims, you hypocrite. And you are always attacking us. Call us mushrikeen. You are calling us mushrikeen, Jews and Christians. Shame on you. First, look at your own broken mirror. You worshippers of Muhammad, and the proof is in front of you. Look how they are praying towards Muhammad, man. The dead guy. They are nothing but necromancers. Worshippers of a dead guy, dead Muhammad. This is why the Sahaba used to drink even the urine. Muhammad peed in a, let's say, in a bowl, guys. Muhammad peed in a bowl. And one of the Sahaba drink from the pee. Why would a Sahabi do that? When Muhammad used to sweat, they collected the sweat of Muhammad and put it on their faces. Why would Muslims do that? When Muhammad used to bleed in war and they clean his wounds, the Sahaba, the companions cleaned the wounds of Muhammad, they collected the blood and they suck the blood. Vampires, man. Sucking the blood of a man. Clearly, Islam is not pagan religion, guys. Clearly, Islam is not a pagan religion, brother. Clearly. Right, Muslims? Brother makes a good point. Hypocrisy 101. Munafiq 101. That's what Islam is. Ya munafiq, son of a munafiq. How dare you to attack us and call us mushrikeen? How dare you, Muslims? Look at your own broken mirror first. Shame on you. We don't worship a man. We worship the Son of God. Right? We worship one God. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. One God. But you Muslims worship Muhammad. Even when you pray, you talk to Muhammad and worship Muhammad. And pray is an act of worship, right, Muslims? When you talk directly to a dead man and you bow down and you pray like this towards a dead guy's grave, a tomb. This is Medina, guys. This is in Medina. This is the heart of Islam. Medina al-Mukarrama, right, Muslims? No, there's nothing called 1 + 1 + 1, you munafiq. Our God is much higher than any mathematical equation. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Spirit, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. God is Spirit. Jesus existed with the Father from the very beginning, and He became flesh. Right? The Word, that eternal Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And the Holy Spirit is the one who always guides us, is the power of God. There is nothing called 1 + 1 + 1. That's your deluded imagination. So keep worshipping Muhammad, ya Ids, ya Munafiq, son of a Munafiq. When you pray, you say, Salamu alayka, ayyuhan nabi. Right? Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You are talking to Muhammad when you pray. You Muhammadan. This is why we call you Muhammadan. Muslim man jawab. Ya Muslim man jawab. Why do you pray to Muhammad when you pray? Call me, Abdu. Why are you praying to Muhammad when you pray? Why are you talking to Muhammad? Salamu alayka ya ayyuhan nabi. Salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi. Right? Salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi. Peace be upon you, O Muhammad. You hypocrite munafiq. Silence me. Refute me. We are live, brother. My Skype is open, brother. Why are you not calling, brother? Do you have any Muslim? Guys, please don't send me a message and say hello. I don't want to receive a hello message. You want a call? Or just don't send me messages, okay? Guys, another hypocrisy of Muhammad. Pay attention. I'm going to show you another hypocrisy of the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad. Look, Muslims in the hadith, they say, the Prophet never used bad language, neither a fahish nor a mutafahish. He used to say, the best among you are those who have the best manners and character. So you have to always have a good character, you know. You have to be like Muhammad, because Muhammad never used bad language. Boy, oh boy, we're going to show you that Muhammad actually used very bad language. Watch. This is islamqna.info, right? Sheikh Muhammad Salih al-Munajjid. This is the Mufti, and he is mentioning where Muhammad said, Muhammad, blessing and peace of Allah be upon him. Allah is praying on him. There's nothing called blessing and peace. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is praying on him and salute him. Messenger of Allah instructed us. So Muhammad instructed the Muslims. If you hear someone boasting in an ignorant manner of his tribal lineage, so if you are a Muslim, guys, if someone, a Muslim, a Sahabi, if you hear him and he's trying to act tough, you know, hey, look at me, I'm boasting, you know, look, you know, my father in the Jahiliyyah, right, in the ignorance, al-Jahiliyyah, right, in the ignorance era before Islam, the pre-Islamic era, then tell this guy who is boasting to bite his father's male member. And do not use a metaphor. Brother, this is not a metaphor, brother. This is not a metaphor. So Muhammad told his Sahaba to go bite on the penis of your fathers. What did the hadith say? The Prophet never used bad language, brother. Wait. You munafiq, son of munafiq. Yes, your Prophet did. Your prophet did, and even Abu Bakr. What about Abu Bakr? He said, go lick the clitoris of a lad. This is not a metaphor, brother. Not a metaphor, brother. You see the foul language of Muhammad? Muhammad is saying that. Where are the Muslims? Yalla ya ya akhwan, yalla ya akhwan. Show me the best of example. Yalla, yalla, yalla. Call me and refute me. Yalla. Say this is fake hadith, brother. I dare you to say this is fake. By the penis of his father, brother? Yes, brother. That's the prophet of Islam, brother. But last time we checked, Muhammad never used bad language. Yes, he did. You munafiq, son of a munafiq. You hypocrite, son of a hypocrite. You remember the tweet of this guy, this Mimi Hijab? He repeated this, right? This is how they do it, yeah. Yes, we can. Guys, for the people who want the links, our brother Phil Herrera, always provides the links under the comment section when we are done, guys. So you have to wait, let's say 10 minutes, 20 minutes, maybe an hour. Our brother Phil Herrera, the admin, his blue name that you see in the live chat, Phil Herrera, he'll always post the links, the sources that we use on our live show in the comment section under this video, okay? So when we are done teaching, you want to save those links, get the links, go back to the comment section, you'll find them, all right? Under the description box, under the comment section. All right, guys? So don't worry, be happy. You can find them always back. So if you want the reference, go back to the live show and wait, let's say 30 minutes, maybe an hour, you know. Maybe Phil Herrera wants to eat something or drink something, and then he will post them. Welcome, Tony King, my friend. God bless you. Welcome. Do we have any Muslim? Huh? Do we have any Muslim who will say, this is fake, brother? This is naive, brother. This is little source, brother. Little, little. Brother, this is little. What about Abu Bakr, guys? Let me do a... On the same page, right? What did Abu Bakr say? I think this is mentioned. Uh-oh. Abu Bakr make it even more beautiful, guys. Look at Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr, the first caliph, guys, after Muhammad dead, after Muhammad died, Abu Bakr became the first caliph, right? The father of Aisha. The father of Aisha. Speaking from cave, Hira, Hira. Abu Bakr became the first caliph. Caliph, caliph. Okay. What did Abu Bakr say? Quote unquote, suck the clitoris of Allah, brother. Brother, the first generation of Muslims, including the Prophet, brother, they had only beautiful words, brother. No bad language at all, brother. Brother, keep sucking of the Allah, brother. This is the number one guy after Muhammad, guys. Any Muslim? Let it sink in, guys. Really, really beautiful words, man. I am convinced after today's live show, I'm going to say my Shahada. And I know many people here will say the Shahada too. After these beautiful words of Muhammad and the first Caliph Abu Bakr. Muhammad says, go buy the penis of your fathers. And Abu Bakr says, suck the clitoris of Allah, brother. Someone is moved by the deep words of Abu Bakr, brother. I hear you, Rab, brother Rab. Contradiction or not, you'll be the judge of that, guys. You will be the judge of that. And Zechariah always says, and I quote, brother makes a good point. Do we have any Muslim? Do we have maybe a Christian who wants to call us? If you are a Christian, you can call, guys. Now we have the Q&A session. If you have any questions, you want to ask us questions, go ahead. You want to call as a Christian, go ahead. Brother, do you have any Muslim? Do you have any Christian? Anybody is free to call. Jason Palmer says, how can anyone take this religion seriously? Well, you tell me, my friend. It is 2020. Wake up, Muslims. Wake up. Where is Fifi when you need him, brother? Where is Mimi, who we are spanking day in, day out? I really lost count, guys, how many times I spanked this Muhammadan, right, who is making Allah look like a slave. Allah is doing harm to the Prophet, brother? Yes, brother. Calling Allah the slave of Muhammad, showing us that actually the real God of Islam is Muhammad. Alhamduli Muhammad, right? Ya Muhammad Hijab. Ya Akhi, Ya Akhi, Ya Akhi. Alhamduli Al-Nabi, Al-Nabi. Brother, they are playing dead. Yeah, they are playing dead, brother. Exactly, Princess Rim. They, you know, when we go live, I mean, how many people are actually doing what we do? Do you see Fifi doing a live show and allowing people to call? No, because he know when he is going to do that and open up his Skype, I am going to be one of the first guys who are going to call him live, and you will see the fun. You will see the fun. But this guy knows, because if he's going to do it, Christian Prince will call, I will call, David Wood will call, Sam Shimon will call, you know, then it's over, brother. His career is going to be over, brother. This is why they don't do what we do. I mean, if you are not a coward, you think that Islam is the truth, open your Skype. Why are you so scared? Right? Why are you so scared? Why are you so scared? Why? Islam is the truth, brother. Zakir Naik, brother makes a good point. Brother makes a good point. Brother. I can't do it, guys. I can't do the voice of Zakir Naik. Yeah, Flea, Fifi, why are you not open up your Skype so I can call you? Right? Why? Mimi Hijab, you have more than 200,000 subscribers, man. Why are you scared? Anyway. Yeah, you know, Muhammad Hijab is so scared, guys. He's so scared because he knows I will remove the hijab from his face and I will put the niqab on him. I will remove his hijab and I will make him put his niqab on him. Yeah. Muhammad Hijab is, you know, in that video, he was crying. He was furious. Muslims are leaving Islam, brother. Any Muslim, any Christian who wants to call, guys, come on. Any questions? Let's see if there are any questions that we can answer in the live chat, guys. Is there any question? Maybe you have a question. Maybe we can help you out. Maybe we can provide something that you are struggling with. Is there any question? Someone is saying, can you talk about the dhikr? They falsely translated as Quran and say only the Quran is protected from corruption. That's a lie, my friend. We all already mentioned this over and over in many of our live shows, Living with Jay. We already mentioned this many times, over and over. According to the Quran, nobody can alter the words of Allah, right? Nobody can alter the words of Allah. Allah is the one who sent down his words, i.e. the Injil, the Torah, the Zabur, which they called, you know, the Psalms. They call it Zabur. The Injil, the Torah, and the Zabur. Those are the words of Allah. And Allah says, no one can alter my words in the Quran. Right? Dhikr is not Quran. Dhikr means the last scripture of the Muslims, right? The Quran confirms, right? Confirming what is between your hands. Musaddiqan ma bayna yadayhi, right? So the Quran confirms the Torah, the Gospel, and the Zabur. Right? That's what zikr means. Confirms. It confirms it. Right? Quran is Quran and zikr is zikr. Right? So it's confirming what is between the hands. Right? Confirming what is between your hands. How can the Quran say in any ayah that the Bible is corrupt? I challenge any Muslim, my friend. What was your name again? If there's a Muslim, I challenge him to give me just one ayah, Living with Jay. If there's a Muslim watching, I challenge you to provide me one ayah where it says that the Bible is corrupted. Just one. I'm not asking for 10. Just one ayah where it says that the Bible is corrupted. Is that a good deal, guys? Is that a fair deal? I'm not asking for 10 ayah. I'm not asking for 20. Just one. Just one. If you can show me one, I will give you $1,000. Just one, my friend, just one. So, the problem is, guys, and I'm talking to the gentleman who just asked this question. The problem is, why do Muslims have to assume that the Bible is corrupted? Because when Muhammad busted himself and he created this mass confusion in the Quran, Muslims much later, centuries later, and this actually started in the 14th century, right? When they started to read our Holy Bible, they came to know, hey, the Bible is actually attacking the teaching of Muhammad. It is contradicting the teaching of Muhammad. It is destroying Muhammad himself, right? And there is nothing called Muhammad in the Holy Bible. As Muslims claim, there's nothing called Quran, there's nothing called anything, no Islam, nothing, right? So they have to assume after the 14th century, right? In the 14th century, this started. So they have to assume the because the Holy Bible is destroying Islam, destroying Muhammad, right? Completely annihilate the teaching of Muhammad. We have to assume that the Bible must be corrupted, brother. But when you say that, you're actually calling Allah and Muhammad liars. Muhammad himself swore on the Torah, right, guys? Muhammad himself swore on the Torah. Right? Muhammad swore on the Torah. He asked for the Torah to be brought. Let me see if I can get you the link. The hadith, guys. Just a Just a second, guys. Bear with me, okay? Okay, I found it. Look. Jay, are you with me, my friend? Jay, are you with me? I hope you're with me. Look. A group of Jews, Okay. A group of Jews came and invited the Messenger of Allah to Kuf. So he, Muhammad, visited them in their school. They said, Abu al-Qasim. So that was his nickname of Muhammad. One of our men has committed fornication. So one of the Jews, pay attention, one of the Jews committed fornication with a woman. That's what the Jews are saying. So pronounce judgment upon them. Now, wait here before we continue, guys. Why do you think the Jews did this? Why did the Jews invite Muhammad? Guys, think with me here. Why did the Jews invite Muhammad to pronounce judgment upon these Jewish women and Jewish men? To show everybody, Jews were really, really smart people, guys. They were brilliant in spanking Muhammad. Because the Jews want to show you that Muhammad is actually confirming the Torah, their Torah. Guys, this is a brilliant tactic by the Jews. Look at these smart Jews, guys. One of our men has committed fornication with a woman, says the Jews. So please pronounce judgment upon them. They placed a cushion for Muhammad. The Jews, they placed a cushion for Muhammad, right? Who sat on it and said, bring me the Torah. So Muhammad is now asking for the Torah. Here, Muhammad fell for the trap. Muhammad fell for the trap of the Jews. Here, Muhammad is confirming the Torah of the Jews. Aha! Guys, so the Torah was given to Muhammad. It was then brought to Muhammad, right? Guys, pay attention. Let me give you the link again for the people who want it. Save it, bookmark it, guys. So the Torah was given to Muhammad. He, Muhammad, then withdrew the cushion from beneath him and placed the Torah on it. So he took the cushion from his underneath him. So basically the judge cushion, right? And he placed the Torah on the cushion, guys. Right? Pay attention. Brilliant move from the Jews. Brilliant. Look what Muhammad then says. I believe in thee. What? The Torah. And in him who revealed thee. Bam! So here Muhammad was busted. Here Muhammad is saying, I believe in God of Israel, in Jehovah. I believe in God, Jehovah. Here Muhammad became a Jew. I believe in Jehovah and the one who revealed thee. Bam! You see it? Brilliant move from the Jews. Here for a split second, Muhammad became a Jew and he had no idea what was happening to him. Muhammad became a Zionist, brother. Muhammad a Zionist, brother. So how dare you Muslims say the Torah is corrupted? Bam! Use this, guys. Use this tactic. Use this method. The Jews did it. Can you learn from the Jews? Whenever a Muslim says to you, the Bible and the Torah are corrupted, show them this hadith, guys. Brilliant move. Copy it. Bookmark it, save it. Guys, look what I'm doing. I have something he called a folder. And look what I'm doing. Learn from me, guys. Look how many hadith I'm collecting. Make a folder and place your hadith. This is Quran. Look. I have all kind of folders to use. Save them, guys. Use them. Right? Help me to help you. Learn from this. Take screenshots. Do what you have to do, guys. So here, Muhammad actually confirmed the Torah and he said, I believe in Jehovah. Right? Because Jehovah sent the Torah. Right? He became a full Zionist, a full Jew. Karian says, I will not defile my computer. Well, yeah, okay. I understand you, Karian. So do you see, guys? Muslims are actually calling their prophet a liar. Muslims call Muhammad a liar when they say the Torah is corrupted. They are actually calling Muhammad a liar. And when they do that, I actually always laugh and they make my job very easy. I love it when Muslims say, when they debate me, when they say the Bible's corrupt, brother. When they say that, I love it. So that's a good chance for me to spank them. I challenge any Muslim to call us and say the Bible is corrupted. The Torah is corrupted, the Injil is corrupted. Do it. If you have any guts, call me now, right here, right now. Yalla ya akhi, yalla. Farjina ard aktafak. Farjini ard aktafak ya akhi. Show me your manhood. Show me what kind of man you are. Call me. Prove to everybody that Rob Christian is a liar. Maybe I'm lying, guys. Allahu alam. Maybe I'm lying. Call me and say to my face and show everybody what kind of liar I am. You have no idea, guys. You have no idea how many comments and messages I receive from Muslims. After we are done teaching. Can you imagine? After the live show, they just put one line. You're a liar, brother. You are saying everything out of context, brother. That's what they always. After we are done, why not during the live show? Why are you such cowards? I mean, talking text is cheap. Talk in the comment section is cheap. Call me. Refute me. I'm spanking your prophet, man. Exactly. Show us the signs of the hadith, brother. Last time they said, guys, they said Fifi is a expert in the science of hadith, brother. Well, Fifi, call me then if you're such an expert. Let's see. Fifi, brother, makes a good point. Where are the Muslims, man, when you need them? Where's the ustaz? Where's the imam? Ah, I see. They are hiding in the bushes. What? Brother makes a good point. May is saying, what you guys all are doing is cognitive bias called chauffeur knowledge. Keep believing this idiot. You idiot, son of an idiot. You're calling me idiot. Prove to everybody that I'm an idiot. I mean, talk is cheap in text. May for you. Prove to everybody that I'm an idiot. I mean, talk is cheap. I can call anybody an idiot, but prove it. Show me how am I lying. You're an idiot, Rob Christian. Rob Christian, you're finished. You're an idiot. All right. I love this, guys. Watch. Look at Mimi Hijab. Because he cannot spank anybody, he will never debate anyone, right, without muting anyone. Look, this is Muhammad Hijab. Look, the peaceful Islam, guy. Peaceful Islam.
Nothing, boy. You're finished already. Look at me. You know you're done. You are. Ali.
Don't forget to take out your umbrellas, guys.
Ali.
لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقاتل المسلمون اليهود فيقتلهم.
We have to kill all the Jews, brother. Even the kids. Every Jew must die, else the judgment day will not start. All the Jews, they are hiding behind the trees. Hiding behind the stone. We will call all of them, brother. Peaceful religion called Islam, brother.
And you have no idea how much I hope Allah is going to curse you
Allah on you,
the rest of your life.
You are Ali. Ali.
Yes, brother. Guys, don't forget to subscribe. Since the sponsor of today, you know, is Mimi Hijab and Fifi, brother Fifi, right? Make sure to subscribe. Smash that like button, guys. Don't forget. Yeah, guys, I hope you took out your umbrellas, man. This guy is like a spitting cobra, man. yeah, please, man, call me and spank me, man. I mean, everyone can say to anyone, you're a liar, you're a hypocrite, you're... Show us my hypocrisy, call me. Show everybody that Rob Kishan is a hypocrite, like Mimi Hijab, like Fifi. Show us our hypocrisy. I challenge you. You know, maybe I'm tired after 14 years, guys. Imagine I'm doing this for 14 years, right? 14 years. Maybe you can finally give me a rest. Maybe you can end my career after 14 years. I will stop doing live shows. I will stop exposing your prophet. I mean, now you have a chance, man. Look how many people are watching. 154 people watching now, right now. If you can silence me, those people will stop coming to my live shows. Right, guys? Yeah, 14 years of service. I'm trying to be very humble. Actually, it's all 15 years already. But show me one Muslim who can refute me. Maybe I can stop, guys. Maybe you Christians will see, hey, look, this Christian apologist, he's a liar. He's an idiot. Right? Blah, blah, blah in text. That's it. Right? Muslims. Blah, blah, blah. When we are live, there's only blah, blah in the text. But when we finish the teaching, guys, they continue their blah, blah in the comment section. Blah, blah. Jesus is a man. You worship a man, brother. Muslims. You are worshippers of Muhammad. Who are you trying to attack, man? You are worshipping Muhammad when he's dead in his grave. Look, this is Medina. This is the tomb of Muhammad, guys. Look. This is the tomb. Look at the gold, guys. This is gold, pure gold. Can you imagine? This is pure gold. And they are worshipping Muhammad in his grave. Look at this madness, man. When you pray five times a day, you are worshipping Muhammad. You are talking directly when you pray. You are talking directly to Muhammad. Salamu alayka. Ayyuha Nabi, right? Peace be upon you, you, O Prophet. Five times a day, man. That's 17 times at least a day, because they keep repeating that, right? 70 times a day they talk to Muhammad. How dare you, Muslims, to attack us? How dare you to call us mushrikeen? Look at your shirk, look at your own hypocrisy first. Wake up, May, you need to wake up. We don't hate you. May, listen, May, we don't hate you. We are showing you your hypocrisy. We are showing the hypocrisy of Muslims. You are worshippers of Muhammad, face it. Anta kafir ibn kafir. Anta mushrik ibn mushrik, ya May. Anta huwa al-mushrik. عرفت علي؟ انت هو المشرك. شوف اخوانك. هاي مش مدينة؟ هاي مدينة المكرمة. I'm sure when you go to Medina, you're going to do the same. I'm sure. And because you are doing this five times a day when you pray to Muhammad. سلام عليك أيها النبي. Right? Guys, because he knows you got Spanish, he's going to write in Arabic. انت. لا انت 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 انت. أنت يا أخي أنت المشرك ابن مشرك. Right? You are the son of a mushrik. You are the son of a mushrik. This is Medina, guys. This is Medina. Here, this is the tomb of Muhammad himself. They are worshipping Muhammad. Look. Look at the behind. Imagine if one of them starts to fart, bruh. Look at this guy. He will die immediately, bruh. He becomes an instant mujahid, brother. Right? Imagine sitting behind and one of them farts, brother. Anyway. Where are the Muslims when you need them? No, this is Medina. Medina is in not Mecca. This is Medina, the second holiest city. Guys, Mecca is in, sorry, the Kaaba and the black stones, right, is in Mecca. This is the tomb of Muhammad in Medina. This is the second holiest city of the Muslims. They call it Medina al-Mukarrama, right? Basically the gracious, glorious Medina, something like that. The tomb of Muhammad himself. Look how they are worshipping him, a dead guy. Necromancy, right? So this May, who is talking garbage in the text, if he goes to Medina, he will do the same exactly, guys. All of them are Muhammadans. Stop calling Muslims Muslims, guys. Learn from me. From now on, it is 2020. We are starting a new year. We started a new year. From now on, call them Muhammadans, because the proof is in front of you. When they pray to Muhammad. When they go to Medina, they worship Muhammad. Yeah, carry on. Those are the Shia. Yeah, the Shia worship their imams. Exactly. The Shia, they worship their imams. Do we have any Christian who wants to call, guys? Do we have any Christian who wants to call us? You want to share something with us, guys? I'm talking to our brothers and sisters in Christ. You want to call? Go ahead. Don't say, Rob Christian, you are not allowing Christians to call. Yes, we do. Don't be shy like the Muslims, guys. Come on. I'm not going to bite. You want to share something, guys, about this hypocrisy, man-made cult, this Munafiq cult? Huh? You want to ask me a question? Was there a hadith about Muhammad being gay? Many, the Steve Jones. Many. We mentioned this over and over in many of our live shows. Let me give you a link you can watch later. All right? About the bisexual prophet of Islam, okay? Let me give you a link. Go watch it after today's live show. Because it's off topic. But let me give you the link to that, okay? Here. And so on and so on. Oh. Here's the link. You can go watch it and see how Muhammad was actually gay, bisexual. And here, this is the link that I used during that live show, which is full of authentic hadith. Right? This is the link that I used to show everybody that Muhammad was a bisexual. Not only that, my friend, the one who asked the question, Muhammad was raped by his own cousin. Ibn Ammi Fahataka Ardi. My cousin raped me, said Muhammad. Right? You can find everything on that link that I just gave you. Bookmark it, save it. Muhammad was a bisexual, and not only that, he was also raped. He was also sexually abused by his own uncle, Abi Talib. His uncle, guys, loved to sleep with Muhammad in one bed, and he asked Muhammad when he was an 8-year-old boy, right? Because Muhammad became an orphan, and his uncle, Abi Talib, took care of him. And Abi Talib was always commanding Muhammad to take off his clothes and sleep with him naked. Naked 8-year-old boy in his uncle's bed. Yeah, messed up, I know. This is why Muhammad was so mentally disturbed during his life. Every time when he went to somewhere, he said everything 3 times. Salaamu alaikum, salaamu alaikum, salaam, everything 3 times. Right? OCD, guys. OCD. This guy was mentally ill, man. He used to walk on the streets of Medina and Mecca, Muhammad himself, the prophet of Islam, and people were calling him Majnoon. Why would you call someone Majnoon? A crazy madman, right? Because Muhammad suffered from mental illness. He was under the black magic spell, right? He suffered from a black magic spell. He forgot to eat his 7 ajwa that day, and one of his enemies cast a black spell on Muhammad, right? And Muhammad was at least 6 months. Other sources even say 1 long year. He used to walk around thinking that he had sex with his own wife. Well, that was not happening. He was dreaming it. He was seeing things exactly, Karian. The Majnoon prophet of Islam. Can you imagine? Where is Allah when you need him? Where is Allah to protect Muhammad? Think Allah was asleep. Guys, thank you for your donations. Thank you, Road FFM. Road FFM is saying, thanks, Rob. Guys, also check out my last upload. Yeah, guys, you can subscribe to Road FM, his YouTube channel, and he's asking you to check out his last upload. It's always good to help out all the warriors in Christ, right? Thank you for your donation, my friend. God bless you. 7 ajwa per day, yeah. Think Muhammad forgot to eat 7 ajwa when he was poisoned by a Jewish woman, and he also forget to eat 7 ajwa when he suffered from the black magic spell. When they took out the hair from his comb, and Muhammad walked around Medina and Mecca like a Majnoon, a crazy, possessed by jinn, a madman. Majnoon means someone who is possessed by jinn. Why would Allah allow his final prophet, the seal of all the prophets, akhi? Alhamdulillah. Why would Allah allow his final prophet to be possessed by jinn? Karian, thank you for your donations too. Karian says, thank you so much, Rob. I gotta go. Bye, guys. Well, thank you for your donation, Sister Karian. May the peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with you and your family. See you later. See you, Lord willing, in a future live show. Guys, I know that Christian Prince will do a live show a couple hours from now. So, since we don't have any callers, I want to ask you guys to download today's live show. So wait at least 20 minutes or so, right? Oh, we have a caller. Okay. Let me take this call first. Hello, Sister Vanessa. Welcome.
Yes, hello.
Hello,
Vanessa. How are you? Can you hear me?
Yes, I hear you loud and clear. How are you?
Okay. Perfect. I'm good. I mean, it's quite amazing. I mean, the information is old but new. Especially the picture you show them going to Mecca and praying at a tomb.
Yeah.
That's like necromancing.
Of course.
The Bible says don't do it.
100% necromancing, exactly. Praying to the dead. Exactly, sister. Yeah.
The Bible says don't do it. So how is that the God of Abraham?
Yeah.
It can never be the God of Abraham.
Never, ever, never, ever. Exactly. Never, ever.
That's
blasphemy. That's an insult to the holy living God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Exactly, sister. Exactly.
So I'm quite amazed. I mean, God is really patient.
Yes.
You know, we as human beings, we hear these things and we are quite shocked. But God sees this every day, hears this every day, and thinks, well, let's give them time. One day, everything will be over. I mean, if Christians are listening to you,
They are hearing you loud and clear. Your life on air, sister. They are hearing you perfectly.
Yes, especially Muslims.
Yeah.
Muslims, turn back to your Maker, the Amen. Real God, the Amen. Only living God.
Amen.
This cannot be a religion. How can you go all the way, spend your money all the way to Mecca,
and Medina,
and all
yeah.
you do
yeah.
is go to the tomb
yeah.
and pray to a dead man?
Exactly.
Number one. Number two, you go there, circumambulate the Kaaba for what?
Exactly.
Don't you guys see for what? Not only that, you go there going up and down, doing a Safa and Marwa. What is that?
Yeah.
Throwing stones.
Yep.
At what? At Satan? You are joking. Satan is a spirit.
Yeah.
God bless you, Brother Rob.
Thank you,
really,
sister.
Really, God bless
you. Thank you. I appreciate it.
It's amazing. I'll continue to listen to you. God bless. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you for
May
calling.
God protect
you. Thank you. You too, yeah. sister. Thank you. Appreciate your call. God bless you.
Thank you. Yeah, bye.
Bye-bye, sister. Bye. Yeah, the lady is... you heard the lady, guys. All right? You heard the lady. She's correct. This is blasphemy, man. This is blasphemy. This is an insult to our holy God. God, guys, God destroyed the Jews. God Almighty destroyed the Jews for worshipping that golden calf. Do you think God will not judge you for your blasphemy, Muslims? You are doing all kind of pagan rituals. You are circling the black stones and the Kaaba. You kiss stones. You touch and kiss the Yemeni corner because you think stones and the corner, the Yemeni corner, can forgive sins, absorb your sins. What's wrong with you, Muslims? Why would you kiss and worship stones? Why would you worship Muhammad, his grave, his tomb? Why would you talk directly to Muhammad when you pray? He is dead. He's rotting in Medina, as you see. He's dead behind his tomb here. Why would you worship him 5 times a day? Talk to him 5 times a day in your prayers. Shame on you. Please leave this man made cold, man. Come back to Jesus. Why, Muslims? Wake up, man. We are not attacking you. We are actually trying to open your eyes. I cannot convert you to Christianity, Muslims. Our job is only show you the truth. It's on you to open your eyes, Muslims. Open your eyes, please. Don't be blind. Right? Don't be blind, Muslims. Unfortunately, most of the Muslims are actually deaf, blind, and mute. Hello, welcome. You're live on air.
Welcome, brother.
Hello, welcome. Welcome. Are you a Christian, my friend?
Yes, I'm Christian.
Okay, hello. You're live on air, my friend. Everybody can hear your voice. Welcome.
Okay. Yes, I have a Muslim co-worker.
Yes.
And I was telling him about, you know, the dhikr and everything. And he's telling me that in Islam, they don't use the logic. They only use faith.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. They don't think, right? Go ahead, my friend. Go ahead. I'm listening. Go ahead. Hello? Try to call back, my friend. Maybe something is wrong. Let me call him back. Hi, Jay. Hi. I lost you for a second, my friend. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. So I was thinking maybe Quran says...
Oh, okay. Again, guys, I'm not sure what's going on. Are you pressing your mute button or something? We lost you again, my friend. We lost you. Maybe his connection is bad. Check your connection and try to call again, my friend. Think something wrong with your microphone, or I'm not sure what kind of program you use or what kind of device you use. Hello, Jay, welcome. Can you hear me?
Yes, I was using my Bluetooth, maybe that's why.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, so I was thinking maybe Quran says something that using the logic is evil to keep them from, you know, leaving Islam.
Are you saying that they say that logic is evil? Is that what you're saying?
This is what I am thinking, because wow. He told me okay. They cannot use the logic.
Exactly. If you can't use logic, you can't think logically. Yeah, what's left then? That means you are only listening. You would never ask questions to understand logic. And the background... Guys, we are middle in a call. Don't call me. Someone is calling. Wait a second till we finish this call. So Muslims are actually in denial. They are deaf, blind, and mute. And the background picture is basically proof what you just said, my friend.
Yeah. Exactly. So they are only believing the sheikhs and imam. They don't want to do any research.
Yeah. And someone in the chat, my friend, is mentioning chapter 5, ayah 101. Yes. They are not even allowed, according to the Quran, they are not even allowed to ask questions. Don't ask, says the Quran. Right? Because the moment you start to question Islam, the moment you start to question the Quran and Muhammad, you know, that means you're already basically, you are actually attacking Islam. So asking questions in Islam is already attacking Islam, because it can make you leave Islam. You can become an apostate, right? So yeah.
But I don't understand this. How, if Islam is the truth, then how can evil conquer the good, right? If Islam is true, no matter how you ask questions,
yes,
you will always believe.
Yes.
This is to prove Islam is false.
Yes, exactly. You know, there's a hadith, my friend, you know, since you mentioned this, there's a hadith about Muhammad. He said, when you go and, let's say, you go and conquer a country, you go to your enemies, never take your Quran with you. Ask yourself this question to the people who are also listening. Why would Muhammad tell his Sahaba, his companions, when you go to war, why should you not take your Quran with you? Because if you, let's say you are fighting and you drop your Quran on the ground, and let's say a Christian or a Jew grabs it, he will see the damaging stuff in the Quran, and you know, you're actually going to give them chance to attack Islam. You're going to give them chance to spank Muhammad, spank the lies of Muhammad. This is why, you know, Muhammad used all kind of tactics, you know. Don't do it, guys, because they, you know, Christians and Jews are smart. They're going to spank me. So don't take the Quran with you.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, you reminded me of this hadith, my friend.
Yeah. This is crazy. Yeah. I see this is similar with all of the, you know, the cults, because even the Jehovah's Witness, they also say, you know, don't search outside of our, you know, content.
Exactly. When you have cults like Jehovah's Witnesses, like the Mormons, like Islam, you know, they are afraid of the questions. And someone in the chat is saying, King Jesus Assyrian says, quote unquote, I guess Muhammad didn't predict the internet. Yes, the internet is the biggest weapon against Islam in 2020.
Prophet Google.
Yeah, Prophet Google, peace be upon him. Exactly. Exactly.
Okay, my friend.
You want to say something else, my friend? Do you want to share something else?
Just I hope that all the Muslims who are listening will have open mind and go take the step to actually look and search some. I think May was saying that the Bible of today is corrupt, but not the Bible of Muhammad time. I challenge her or him to go and look at the manuscript.
Yeah.
It says the same as today.
Exactly.
So this is my message.
Thank you, my friend, for calling. God bless you. And. You can always call us, my friend. Welcome. Thank you for calling. Bye-bye. Someone else called me. Let me call this gentleman back. Let's see what... Let me call him back. My friend Festus, I'm calling you, Festus. You called me when I was calling the gentleman, or talking to the gentleman. Okay, maybe he will call me back. Oh, we have our brother Taqiyawatch with us. Welcome, Taqiyawatch TV. Guys, we have a really nice brother here. Taqiyawatch, you can subscribe to his YouTube channel. I love his videos. He is really a good video editor, and he's a good researcher, and he's putting a lot of beautiful videos together. So make sure to also subscribe to his YouTube channel. Support all the warriors, guys, okay? Taqiyawatch, if you want, you can call me live too, my friend. Taqiyawatch, you can call me, my friend. Hello, Festus, welcome. You're live
now. How are you?
Hi, I'm good, welcome. Are you a Christian, my friend?
Yeah, I'm a Christian.
Okay, go ahead, you're live on air.
Yeah, I just wanted to, I thought I would call it on, but I will just try to share this. When I look at the scripture very well, from Genesis to Revelation,
yes,
we see that God deal with many prophets. And one thing is that every prophet never have his own benefit.
No.
What I'm trying to say is that,
exactly.
That yeah. No any prophet in the Bible, there's no one that God gave message from himself to people for his benefit. I was talking to his sister yesterday, and I realized, I look at the Quran,
yeah,
that the benefit of Prophet Muhammad,
yeah,
from him to his people that God gave him, I've never seen any prophet in the scripture, in the Bible.
Exactly.
Moses,
exactly.
Joshua,
mm-hmm,
Jeremiah, Nehemiah, that said, God want me to have this. Like, you are the one, you can marry every believer woman.
Yeah.
You are the one, no one should marry your wife after his death.
Yes.
If somebody comes to your house to eat, let them go. So I realize, is a man talking? What do you think about that? Not God, because
yes,
I see.
Exactly.
And you are the one that delivered the message to people, not like a prophet came. So thou says the Lord, God said to me that Muhammad, our prophet, should have all the women. But you are the one that told them that God told you.
Yes.
And look at the scripture, there's no one in the Bible that any prophet that God gave message to him to deliver for its own benefit.
Exactly.
I wanted to throw light on that. What do you think about that, sir?
Well, I have to agree with you, because if we go to tafsir of the Quran, my friend, actually Muhammad had 16 privileges that no other Muslim had. 16. Not one, not two, but 16 privileges. Especially the 10th privilege was that if Muhammad looked upon a married Muslim woman, her husband must divorce her and give her immediately to Muhammad so Muhammad can F her. What kind of prophet is it? Is this a prophet of God or prophet of Satan?
I think that must be Satan.
Yeah, if you are attacking a tribe, let's say a Jewish tribe, the big screen TV goes to Muhammad. The small screen TV goes to a normal Muslim, right? What kind
yes.
of, what is this, a prophet or is this?
And the only thing is that it's not like other prophet is saying this should happen to the prophet, but is the one telling them God told him.
Yeah, look at this. This is the 10th. This is my friend. This is the 10th. Privilege of Muhammad. This is chapter 33 tafsir, chapter 33 ayah 50 of the Quran. This is Quran tafsir, okay? Not my tafsir, this is tafsir of Al-Qurtubi. It says Al-Ashir, the 10th privilege. Idha waqa'a basarahu ala imra'a wajib ala zawjiha talaquha wa halla lahu nikahuha. So let me translate. If Muhammad looks upon a woman, right, if he fell in love with a married woman, her husband, right, must divorce
yes.
her immediately And it's halal for Muhammad to start effing her immediately. Can you imagine, guys?
Can you imagine
a married woman? Is this not nasty? Is this a man of God, guys?
I don't think so.
And
secondly, is that when I look at the Quran and I think the Christian, we need to make a clear distinction between them.
Yeah.
Number one, our heaven is not the same. We have totally different heaven. I was looking, I don't know whether you know the scripture, I think Surah chapter 76, I don't know what I'm right, that God told them he's going to give them a big breast. In heaven,
exactly.
I don't know what I'm quoting right, but there's a scripture that I look in the that God is going to give you a woman with a big breast.
Yes,
is that all what you are working for? That's
yes.
What
chapter
God
78, my friend. Chapter 78, ayah 33. Wakawaiba atraba. Wakawaiba atraba. Chapter 78, ayah 33. Let me show you, since you mentioned this. Just to can you look at the screen, my friend?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Let me go to the right ayah so everybody can read it. This is a false translation. Let me switch to translation for a little bit. Okay. It says, وَكَوَاعِبَ أَطْرَابَ. Translation, and maidens, i.e. houris, with swelling breasts. Really, Allah has no business. He has no other things to do but talk about swelling breasts of houris. When you go to the brothel called Jannah, the sex club of Allah in Jannah. وَكَوَاعِبَ أَطْرَابَ. Swelling breasts, brother. Beautiful swelling breasts, like melons. Pow, pow. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
I think they are working on the... I think the Lord will open the Muslims' eyes, because I realize that it's the man that just relating, using God for his own, telling them, God told me. There's no other prophet telling that, oh, Prophet Muhammad, this is what the Lord said, like other prophet in the Bible. Yeah. Like David said, God sent a prophet to him. You took somebody's wife. David never came and said, oh, this God told me to have this woman.
No, David was punished, right? David was punished by God. He was punished. God forbid. God forbid. It's an insult to our holy living God to steal someone else's wife, right?
Yes,
so what did God do? He punished King David, and King David repented from the heart, and he was forgiven, right? God is merciful. He forgives our sins. Everybody here who's watching and listening, if there's someone who says, I'm not a sinner, you're a liar. Everyone is a sinner. This is why we need to ask God for forgiveness, right?
Yes.
God, please forgive me for my sins. That's what we do when we pray, Christians. But Muhammad, different story. Muhammad, different story. He had the privilege to steal your wife.
I think he's the man made for himself. With any that they, I think that we pray that the Lord will open their eyes and think, because there's no any woman... There's no benefit for you at the end in heaven. Man is the one that's going to have all this woman there over. Even a woman, you're going to share your man on this earth. And in heaven, you're still going to share your man.
Yes.
There's no doubt about it. You share your man on earth. You're still going to share your man in heaven. Your heaven of Allah. You're going to share your man with 70 virgin. And also, you're going to share it on earth too. So there's no gain for any woman. I pray the Lord will open their eyes.
Amen.
I just want to thank you for a
thank
good
you.
Job.
Thank
and
you
I pray the Lord will strengthen you and
thank
the Lord
you.
Will bless you. And
appreciate
also, I encourage
it.
Everyone to support you for what you are doing, because you are doing a great job to open our eyes and to get more understanding.
Thank you, my friend.
To be able to do this. God bless you, sir.
Thank you. God bless you too. Thank you for calling, my friend.
Welcome.
You're always welcome to call us, my friend. Thank you
thank
for calling.
You. Thank you.
God bless. See you. See you. Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate that. Is there any other Christian or maybe a Muslim who wants to call, guys? The line is open if you want to call us live. I want to take a last call and we'll wrap this up, guys. Okay, we have Vanessa. Okay, take this call again. Hello, Vanessa. Welcome back again. Go ahead.
I'm sorry, brother. I just have to add to what that brother
no,
just
said.
No,
don't be sorry. It's a blessing to have you, my sister. Go ahead.
Thank you. You know, the Bible says, I don't know, I was made to learn verses as a child, and they are helping me today. The Bible says, if a prophet who calls himself a prophet prophesies, and all of his prophecies come to pass, but one of them doesn't come to pass, is a false prophet.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says also, even if all his prophecies that he prophesied come to pass, and then he says to the people, come, let us go and worship another God.
Yeah.
They should stone him. They should kill him.
Yes. Deuteronomy 18, sister, Deuteronomy 18, 20. Right?
I don't know. I just have that in mind that I was told this. And I started to read the Bible for myself, and it became, and God used the Bible for me. Yeah. So in both ways, Muhammad failed. So the other brother was saying, I don't think this is from God. Yeah. It is not from God.
Yeah.
Both ways. This is how to test if a prophet is genuine or not.
Yes.
Both ways, Muhammad failed. Number one, none of his prophets came to prophecies came to pass.
Yeah.
Number two, come, let us go and worship another God. He was, I was listening to Brother Christian Prince.
Yes.
That he went to kiss the black stone, and the people of Quraysh were like insulting him, and he went to kiss the black stone. So, can someone tell me if this is pre-Islamic?
Yeah.
And you are still doing it. Can someone tell me? I mean, has anyone taken away your brains?
Yeah. Yeah. Since you, sister, just a second, since you mentioned that, if we go to Deuteronomy and it's on the screen, I know you can't see the screen because of your connection.
Can't.
Yeah. But let me read this. This is Deuteronomy 18:20. Deuteronomy 18:20. But the prophet who presumes to speak a word in my name, which I have not commanded him to speak, or who speaks in the name of other gods, like Allah, right? That prophet shall die. So if Muhammad actually walked in the time of Moses, Moses himself would have ordered his men to pick up stones and stone Muhammad to death.
And stone him.
Yeah.
Yes.
You see it?
Yes.
Any prophet, any so-called prophet who speaks of other gods like Allah, because Allah is not Jehovah. We know that.
Yes.
That prophet shall die. So Moses himself, together with his men, would pick up stones and stone Muhammad to death. So if there's a Muslim, never ever, if there's a Muslim watching or listening, never ever dare to mention the name of Moses on your tongue. Never ever compare Muhammad to Moses, because Muhammad would have killed Moses with stones. With stones, brother.
Moses would have killed Muhammad.
Yeah, exactly. He would.
Yeah, not Muhammad would have killed Moses.
No, Moses himself. Yes, Moses.
Yes. Yes.
Muslims don't know this. Muslims are deaf, blind. They don't know this, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
They
you
are
know,
denial.
It's through this knowledge that I can answer Muslims online. There was a time I was walking, and a young girl, you can imagine the hatred they put into them. A young girl, maybe 10 years old or 12. Yeah. Came to me and said, you are mushrikeen, you are worshipping dead God, you are doing this and that. And
who's worshipping? The screen is in front of everybody. Who's worshipping a dead guy? We?
And
even in Islam, Jesus is alive, right? In Islam, we are not worshipping a dead guy, we are worshipping our holy Lord who is in heaven. Muhammad is dead in his grave. And you still worship him when you go to Medina.
And they're still worshiping. And how Satan is really evil. How can you do this and still have the courage, like the ISIS people? The first thing they do is go to the Catholic churches and destroy the figures there. But you are doing the same thing. You are doing even worse.
Yeah.
You are necromancing, talking to a dead man. So how do they have that courage to go and start killing Christians and just love all his...
His videos are great, yeah. Make sure, guys, to subscribe to his YouTube channel. of our brother.
Of course, I subscribe to.
Yeah.
Yes, there is this question that always props up in my mind because of all his videos that he gets together. Yeah. One is, you see, when you see them dancing, you know, the last one he put online, you see Mohammedans really grooving and everything.
I saw that video, yeah.
And then you always see black. Yeah. You always see black people, the way they really dance sensually. Yeah. There is one, I don't know who put it online,
yeah.
one black man
yeah.
going in front of someone looking like Sheikh, sitting there like the little god in his corner.
Yeah, they are good dancers, actually. They dance much better than you and me together. Have you seen them dance? Those people,
No, for that, you know the thing that comes to my mind. The thing that comes to my mind is, there is this hadith that says, okay, you have to wash after putting your male part into a goat, into the anus of a man, into this and
oh,
that.
Oh, man, yeah. Don't let me start about that.
Could it be that these blacks are being used for that kind of a thing?
Disgusting.
This is what comes to my mind. Because this black man went in front of a sheikh that was sitting there cool and looking, and he was rolling his butt before this man, which is actually not acceptable in Islam, at least from the outward appearance, right?
Yeah.
And he was doing that like a call boy. You know, you say call girl, like a call boy.
Yeah.
Could it be that they use blacks for that kind of a thing?
Yeah.
And of course, they know how to cover up, you know, especially the Arabs. They really know how to cover up.
Yeah.
They would say, well, Shia people do that.
Yeah.
Could it be that they are being used for that kind of a thing? Do you understand my question, Brother Rob?
Yeah, well, Shia are something else, yo. These people, they are actually, you know, I always say Sunni worship Muhammad. These are Sunni people that you see on the background picture. And Shia worship Fatima, they worship Ali, the sons of Ali. So that's the difference, basically. Shia and Sunni, they are all pagans, right? Sunni worship Muhammad and Shia worship the house of Muhammad.
My question is, since that hadith, I don't know if you know the hadith I'm talking about. The hadith say, when you finish doing this with the anus of the man or of the animal or this and that. So that means they are allowed to do all that filthy thing.
Yes, they are.
Right?
Yeah.
So there is no difference between Shia and Sunni.
Sunni, bestiality, basically. That's what you're talking about.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Disgusting, I mean, if they can put it in the anus of a man,
yeah,
are they doing it to these blacks that really do like slaves when they are dancing among the Arabs? Because I see many of them online.
Yeah.
Is it what?
Well, last time when you called, we mentioned the thing. You know, there was a video. There's a video circling around on YouTube. About a guy, he called on a live show, of a Muslim live show, and he asked him a question. I want to become a jihadi, and I want to put a bomb, a bomb in my behind, right? So this jihadi is asking. He's a jihadi. He says, "Is it okay if I let my other friends, Muslim friends, F me from behind?" So bomb can become wider so the bomb can fit in. He said, yeah, brother, it's halal, brother. As long you don't do it, you can be a homosexual if it's for jihad, but it's haram to be a homosexual for other stuff, right? So if you want to go and blow yourself up and you put a bomb in your, let your friends F you, right, from behind. Homosexuality is okay as long it's only for jihad, brother. Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah. You see the hypocrisy of these people? Nasty, hypocrite, munafiq Muslims. Yeah. Sodomy is halal when it's only for jihad, brother.
Mm.
Yeah.
And they said someone really did it in the States.
Mm.
Someone, he was caught, he couldn't commit the havoc, but they found someone putting some explosion in his behind.
Yeah, exactly.
In the States, that's what brother Christian said during one of his online.
Yeah.
Well, let me leave you.
Yeah, thank you for calling, sister. Yeah.
Thank you too.
Thank
God
you,
bless
Colin.
You.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. That chair watch. Thank you. God bless you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. We appreciate it. Thank you. See you. Guys, I want to address this Abdul in the text. Abracadabra. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? Are you going to play in the Bad Boys movie, Last Bad Bull? What's wrong with you, man? Anyway, he's addressing Marjanati. Did just silence you? 1 Kings 11:3. He had 700 wives of the royal birth and 300 concubines, and in fact, they did turn this heart away from the Lord. Are you talking about Solomon? I think this is about Solomon, right? My friend, you're not telling us anything new. Everybody is a sinner, right? King David sinned, King Solomon sinned. All of us are sinners. God punished King Solomon. God punished King David for their crimes. And they repented. You're actually telling everybody, these are humans, they are sinners. Yes, we can sin. We do sin. We ask forgiveness so God can forgive us for our sins. But Muhammad, his Allah, allowed him to sin. Are you blind? Are you a hypocrite? Yes, you are. You don't see the difference, right, brother? Muhammad stole the wives of Muslim males of his Sahaba, right? He had many privileges. He was allowed to steal other people's wives. And it is halal for him. But you are such a hypocrite. You are such a deluded Muslim. You don't see that when people like King David, people like King Solomon did that, God punished them for their crimes. But Allah, the fake moon idol of Islam, the moon idol of Islam, actually allowed Muhammad to do that. You see this munafiq hypocrite Abdul? Thank you for reminding us that even people like King David and King Solomon were sinners. Right? Thank you for showing us that your prophet is actually God himself in Islam. This is why you Muslims worship him. And he had many privileges that you normal Muslims don't have, right? Thank you for reminding us that. And thank you for showing everybody that you are a coward. You will never ever call me because you're going to get spanked. Right? Coward? Talking in the chat is cheap, my friend. Talk in chat is cheap. You want to say something? Call me and prove us wrong. Right? And thank you for providing that mankind are sinners and we will be punished for our sins. But God of the Holy Bible is merciful and he forgives sins. So if you repent, God will forgive you. If you truly repent. Right? But Muhammad did all kind of horrendous sins, crimes, stealing other wives, stealing the wives of people, of men. And Allah said, it's okay, go ahead. Muhammad slept with the Coptic slave Maria al-Qobtiyya, right? His wives busted him. Allah said, don't listen to them. Do whatever what you need to do. Keep effing the slave, brother. And then Aisha, she was not stupid. She said, and I quote, "Ma ara rabbuka illa yusara fi hawaka ya Muhammad." I see your Lord hastens to fulfill your sexual desires, Muhammad. She wasn't stupid. Aisha knew this guy is a scam. Muhammad, her husband, is a scam. He created many privileges for himself, right? Like this 10th privilege, right? If he looks upon a married woman, her husband must immediately divorce her, and it became halal for him to F her immediately. What kind of prophet is this, man? Is this a prophet or is this an agent of Satan? Right? What a shame. What a shame to be a deluded Muslim, a blind Muslim, attacking the Bible, but at the same time don't see that your prophet was a nasty sinner. And actually Allah, he used Allah, right, as his slave to fulfill his sexual desires, right, Muslims. Like brother Mimi Hijab said, Allah, the slave of Muhammad, praises the Prophet. Alhamdulillah, Muhammad, right? But the Quran says, Alhamdulillah faqat. All praise to Allah only and Allah only. But here, Muhammad Hijab is actually proving how Muslims are actually worshipping Muhammad. Even Allah is the slave of Muhammad. Allah is doing harm to the Prophet. Yeah, suddenly Allah became the slave of Muhammad. So who is actually the real God in Islam? The Prophet, Muhammad. Thank you, Mimi Hijab. Thank you for showing us that you Muslims are worshippers of Muhammad. You are Muhammadans. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. You hypocrite Munafiq. This is why we chose the topic of today, guys. Any Muslim? Maybe we can take a last call, guys. If you want to call, this is your final chance. Else, we're going to wrap this up, guys. I know Christian Prince will do a live show in 1 hour and 30 minutes from now, if I'm not mistaken. So you can take a break. Go eat something, guys. Drink something. Have a nice dinner, maybe. Depends on where you live. And you can continue from there. Is there any last caller, guys? Is there any Muslim or a Christian who wants to call? Final chance. Final call, guys. I can take one call and then we'll wrap this up. Anyone? Abracadabra, you donkey. We already addressed that, you donkey. I know it's you. I know who you are, Abracadabra. It's you, ultimate shirk, Mr. Rashad Khalifa boy. I know it's you. I know. Rashad Khalifa boy, keep following, keep worshipping Rashad Khalifa, your final prophet, actually. He's ultimate shirk, Michelle. It's ultimate shirk. He's a fake Muslim. I don't want to pay attention to any fake Muslim. We run the real Muslims, not Rashad Khalifa boys. Any Muslim, any Christian who wants to call? All right, guys, I think we are out of calls. Please, guys, don't forget to smash that like button, destroy the like button, click on the subscription box too, or subscription button too. And don't forget also to click on the notification bell to receive notifications when we go live. I'm getting a little bit tired, guys. I'm really busy, as you know, guys. God is good. And my wife is pregnant. I'm really busy in my personal life at the moment. But I really try to make some time to do live shows too. Do small videos too for the people who don't have time to watch a 2 hour or 3 hour live show. I understand that, you know. So this takes a lot of me, but you know, we have to keep continue do this, guys. Not many people do what we do, unfortunately, but it is what it is. You know, I know the Lord always provides. Thank you for your support, guys. Thank you for your donations. Thank you for watching our live shows. Please download our today's live show, guys. If you like some parts, download the video, cut the parts that you like, and upload them on your social media accounts. Help me to help you. If you can help one Muslim out of this cult, you've already done an amazing job, guys. All right. Thank you for watching. Jesus is Lord. Muhammad is a false prophet who created all kinds of privileges for himself. He used Allah for his own sexual desires and power lust. And as we mentioned, Aisha knew. She said, "Ma ara rabbuka illa yusara fi hawaka ya Muhammad." I see that your Lord hastens to fulfill your desires, Muhammad. Right? And we showed you the hypocrisy in Islam. We showed you what kind of hypocrite Muslims are in 2020. And we showed you the hypocrisy of Muhammad himself. So if you are interested, go back and rewatch today's live show. Download it, rewatch it. And don't forget that our brother Phil Herrera, the admin, is always providing their sources in the comment section. So if you want to have the resources, the sources, go back and find them in the comment section. Please pray for our admins. Don't forget to subscribe to the Warriors, other Warriors YouTube channels. Thank you for watching. Jesus is Lord and Muhammad is a scam. Islam is nothing but a man-made sex cult. Thank you for watching and God bless.